So today's video, we're diving into 5 to-do list applications making waves in the space right now. What we're doing is diving into these new applications that have a different take on to-do list experiences. And what we'll be doing is sharing how they work, maybe giving you a few early opinions, and also giving you some insight into how you could potentially use them. These applications are fairly new, so we'll have a timestamp if you want to skip ahead to specific sections, and all of the relevant websites that will be listed below. So before we begin, folks, we're sponsored today by Pipedrive. You can check Pipedrive out below, we've got a great deal with them, but here is a little bit more about them before we begin this video.
No matter how much experience you have selling your product, Pipedrive will make it easier, bringing you better, more engaged leads 24/7 so you can focus on the right people at the right time and convert them to deals in your sales pipelines, which can be fully customized to visualize your process. Every call and email are automatically tracked, and say goodbye to repetitive tasks like sending routine follow-up emails. Workflow automation can do it all, which frees up time to gather insights and measure performance against set goals, no matter where you are. Pipedrive, designed to keep you selling.
So when it comes to new to-do list applications in 2021, there's a few newer options, and I want to start by introducing a different type of to-do list application, which is rearing its head most recently. And I would call this a consolidation to-do list application. We're mentioning the first two that sort of fall under that category, but one is very much a team tool and the other is very much a personal tool. However, we'll explain how they work. Now, so the first one in the list is called Friday. Yes, you've heard it. We've got Monday.com, we've got Friday now. There's probably a space in the productivity area for Wednesday, Thursday, and Tuesday app developers. But Friday is essentially a more focused team tool that allows you to bring your tasks and meetings together in the planner. Now, it's really interesting as a concept because you are met with a planner in the experience to organize your own week, but you also have a way to collaborate with other people on things like routines, goals, and also the feed, so you and your team can keep updated at how other people are working. You can also create meeting notes. It's quite a diverse application when it comes to productivity, but a very interesting one at that. But we're going to focus on that core planner concept inside of Friday. The planner concept itself is really cool, so you're met with all of your sort of work activities. You can connect things like your Google Calendar, your Slack, your Asana, Todoist, Trello, Outlook, whatever you specifically use as your sort of calendar and tasks. And what will happen is you can start seeing some of the tasks in there. And in Friday, you can basically start adding them to your day. You can add things like routines that commonly happen. For example, could be daily stand-up or some, you know, routine sessions that you may create, like book reviews that you may do at a set time period. But it also allows you to add focus time too. You can outplan your goals and also your tasks. And the good thing is it keeps it updated, so it's always in sync with your to-do list applications of choice. So this is what I mean by consolidated application. Very cool in terms of bringing in that information without you having to go to all these separate applications, which might be suitable if you say use Todoist for your personal, Trello for your work, and maybe Asana for another team that you work with or an external client. Very cool concept, very new and fresh, but they have some team abilities. So this one is free for solo use to use. However, they do have a pro plan for team members at $6 per person per month, which if you're using this as tasks, it could be a good starting hub for that. So number 2 is a bit more detailed. This is an application called Akiflow. Now, I want to touch on the pricing first because it's a little bit more premium than you would expect. It's free forever. They do have the ability to add 4 integrations and 1 calendar, but it basically doesn't allow you to share time or see time zones. But that is just to get you sort of started on the plan. But if you did want to commit, $15 per month. So much more of a more premium application. You do get a 14-day free trial if you want to check it out. And this app is available through Mac and Windows. And I've skipped past what it actually does. This application essentially brings your tasks together with your calendar events, much like the application we just checked out. However, this is done in, I would say, a bit more of a structured manner. In my opinion, I think Friday is more for teams. This is more for solo users. Essentially, you can see on the sidebar all of your sort of today items that are coming in from different applications. For example, it could be Todoist, Slack messages, the Chrome places that you've clipped. So you can have integrations varying from different applications. You can have one from Asana, for example. And then what you can do is you can have your calendar header on the right-hand side, which is really cool. But you can start connecting up, for example, dragging a task when you want to do it in the calendar and start seeing them against your specific pieces of work. It's quite an interesting concept because, again, consolidating information and helping you to keep on track. They have a really cool like Mac menu bar feature where if you do have a meeting coming up, you can automatically join in the call. And they also have what Superhuman has, a really solid command bar, which allows you to do things like shortcuts. That, for example, if you wanted to type a task in, you could start planning it automatically, saving you a bit of time if you learned that concept. So it really does sort of promote the time blocking concepts in these applications. But I thought I'd draw attention to this because it's quite a new application, but one that is quite interesting. And hopefully I should be doing a full review on it soon. So next up, number three is Planny 5. Now, if you're someone who has already checked out applications like this, this is sort of a bit like Sorted 3, Things 3 design style application. It's available for iOS and Mac, but essentially it's already in its fifth edition. They've had 4 or 5 years worth of development of this application. And this app helps you to do very simple things like complete the daily to-dos, plan your day intelligently using one of their sort of analysis of what tasks you've got, and it brings it in very interesting, and also plan ahead with projects and activities. This is more of a, I would say, in between Things 3 and Reminders as a sort of mid-level application. It's priced at a fairly reasonable $14.99 per year, so not per month, per year, which is fairly reasonable. And Planny 5 seems to be growing in attention as they, you know, do more and more releases. So next up is actually one that's not officially released yet. This one is actually from the folk at Superlist. Superlist is aiming to build the future of to-dos, and it's been hinted for probably about 2 years now since the team left Wunderlist. However, they're aiming to do a tool that's built for teams but made for people, so sort of like to-do list for teams. One that is focused on you to help, you know, for example, you structure your day that's a bit differently because obviously everyone's different in your team. Also private by design in an effort to try and keep your data secure and safe, and highly collaborative for those who work synchronously and asynchronously, as well as embedding routines. So the application is actually developed by the founder of Wunderlist. So you're going to get a couple of folk who are there from Wunderlist. You know, Christian Rabbit, for example, already been at Pitch. So he's created another company called Pitch. And you've got other team members like Brandon Arnold, Marcel K. Ding, Stefan Kierdel, and Ben Kubuto. But very interesting project in terms of what it could offer in the future. And I think it'll be more of the premium end of the productivity to-do list app market. So finally, number five is one that you probably will be very familiar with. Evernote has recently released Tasks, allowing you to add your tasks in Evernote and add due dates, reminders, and also view them in a new Tasks area inside of your sidebar. So a great addition by Evernote, something they really should have added a long time ago, but something they finally added now, allowing you to manage your tasks. So I guess to-do list, this new to-do list is Evernote, which is weird to say. So they do have a new function that really replicates some and the majority of features that you'll see inside of things like reminders applications. Anyway, folks, I really hope you enjoyed today's feature. Let me know which one you're most excited for, if you're excited for them. I think apps like Akiflow and Friday will be an interesting concept as we move forward in the future. It's really weird adding this layer on top of applications you might already use, but if it promotes a stronger methodology and framework to the way you work, then I think people are more willing to invest in it just for the sheer fact that it promotes that sort of quality and improvement to the way that you work. Anyway, folks, a big thank you. If you'd like to subscribe, it'd be great to have you. But I look forward to you checking all of these out and seeing some of your comments below. Anyway, guys, thank you very much, and I'll talk to you soon. Cheerio.